Individuals who dump trash illegally have many enemies.
If it's not permitted, it is garbage, basically. And they will prosecute it. And that also extends to any other officer within the state of Florida that has state jurisdiction, whether it be Key West Police Department, Monroe County deputies, anyone on the water can enforce that.
In 2001, Florida law enforcement caught a pair of individuals dumping illegal materials into the ocean. What they found horrified them.
What happened was that they actually confiscated their GPSs and downloaded the numbers. We were suspicious that many of the numbers located in these individuals' GPS units were possibly areas that the structures they put out there were illegal. They were not legal traps. Much of it consisted of cut-up dumpsters. There was old bathtubs, car hoods, corrugated metal, as well as wonderboard and PVC filled with concrete.
Cut off pieces of dumpsters, wash machines, bathtubs, refrigerators, old tanks. The latest thing is pieces of wonder board on PVC, small pieces of PVC pipe that supports it. And none of that is legal to put in the water at all.
What we did is we documented each individual piece using techniques that we use in our injury assessment procedures. Each piece was measured to determine the extent of the environmental damage caused by the placement of these structures on top of live communities such as seagrass and hard bottom.
So far, we've pulled out 65 tons of debris that was put in the water, and this is only from two cases. We know there's more out there, but it's just a matter of investigating and finding out who's putting it in. Now we have enforcement on the water all the time. We have enforcement on land too, and we see some of this stuff piled up, and we can kind of associate it with the different people that are putting it in. So we keep a pretty good eye on night and day on what's going out there.
There are probably hundreds or thousands more illegal structures out there that we are unaware of. If you add up the hundreds of locations that we went out and dove and took a look at and added them all together to see what kind of environmental damage was done, we were pretty overwhelmed.
Within this regulated industry, there is an allowance for artificial reefs. Both the Florida Keys National Marine Sanctuary and the Environmental Protection Agency issue limited permits for artificial reefs.
The artificial reefs that are permitted through the sanctuary in the state of Florida are highly scrutinized in various ways. The material which the artificial reef is made out of has to meet certain guidelines. They have to be clean of any kind of contaminant that may cause environmental concern in the present or in the future. A lot of engineering is looked at as well. Coastal engineers take a good look at the wave dynamics of the area where these artificial reefs are put down to ensure that these things will not shift in the event of a major storm or a hurricane.
dangers from unpermitted artificial reefs are many. When an artificial reef is legally placed, a survey of the seafloor is required to ensure that the bottom is barren. People who heave garbage overboard have no regard to the impact they are causing on the marine ecosystem. Legal fishing for the spiny lobster is a livelihood for many families in the Florida Keys. As in other industries, those who break the law make it harder for honest citizens to make a living.
The people who are practicing this illegal fishing are not only causing ecological and environmental problems, but socioeconomic problems as well. The fisherman who is out there day in, day out, pulling his traps, trying very hard to make a livelihood with his permit and do it by the rules, is being impacted far greater than I can even imagine.
While one boat fishes legally, his neighbor may have an unfair advantage by fishing habitats illegally placed. It isn't the Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission that is hurt, but the spiny lobster and those who make a living by the rules. The number of lobsters caught in the Florida Keys in 2001 was the lowest in almost 25 years. The causes of this drop are uncertain, but the effects of lobster condos on a struggling industry could prove to be devastating.
Some people may think that the only way they can be caught doing this is by being caught putting it in the water, but that's not the case. Just the simple fact that they have it in their boat or they're towing it out behind their boat is enough for prosecution under state statutes.
While there is no irrefutable proof that casitas keep lobsters from propagating, there is undeniable evidence that unpermitted artificial reefs are damaging to the marine habitat and lobster fisheries. The greed of a few could mean disaster for many. The dumping of anything in the ocean or bay is illegal. Lobster condos wreak havoc on coral reefs, seagrass beds, and especially lobster populations. Those who sneak around in the dark of night are committing a crime against their neighbors, the marine environment, and the spiny lobster.